And this song is a bit progressive, but it requires some thinking. So, you know, it's one thing to play a three-chord song like Louie Louie. That song doesn't require a lot of thinking. You got three chords, and that's the song all the way through. And it's a fun song to play. You don't have to really count. Song like this, especially when you're talking about a break where there's a keyboard going on, and you want to be in tune with the rest of the band, and there's a tight break coming up, you better be counting. Because if you're not, you're going to get lost. And yeah, that's not cool when you're playing live. So let's run through that again. It goes from 8 measures on D, then 4 measures on A, then after 4 measures on A, then you start the descend on A. And on that descend, it goes. So you are basically, when you start that descent, you're playing each chord change one measure. And you're stepping down a half step each time. So the whole band's doing that, it's sounding great, okay? You start losing count on that, it's not going to sound great. So after the second time through that descend, then it goes down to F. So you descend from F sharp down to F. Now you're at F for 2 measures. Then you jump up to D for 2 measures. Then you go back into A. Now A is 4 measures. And once you're back in A, you know that bridge is coming up. And that bridge goes like this. So you play that 4 times, that whole pattern, which goes from D, F, G5, back to F5, back to D. So let's play that whole rhythm through. You count it out, you play it, and that's the rhythm that's going on behind the keyboard solo. Play that bridge again and then run into basically the breakdown, okay, which is, you know, single note pattern, kind of pentatonic in nature. That breakdown on that pattern, at the end of that, the end of the bridge, basically, I call it the end of the keyboard solo, there's a bridge, okay? It bridges from one part of the song to the next. Most songs have them. They're usually about halfway through the song. Not always, but this particular song, that's how it goes. So at the end of the keyboard solo, the whole band is coming in with that whole, that D to F to G, back to F pattern. The start of that pattern is just a pentatonic pattern that starts in the note of D, or C, I'm sorry, C. So you walk it up and then you walk it back down. The only difference on the walk down is you're doing a it's kind of a blues pentatonic scale. You're doing a half step walk down on the descend. So, you hit D, then you hit the A, hit the G sharp, hit the G, the F, the D, and the C. And that's the end of the bridge. Then it goes into the next verse. So that's the third verse. So the way that the song works is you've got the intro. You've got the first verse, you've got the second verse. You've got the keyboard solo. You've got the bridge that, you know, run there, and then back into the third verse. So I played you the third verse, and it's the same as the first and second. It just repeats itself. So after the third verse comes the guitar solo. And basically, Ritchie Blackmore starting off, and I'm going to walk you through this pretty slow, okay? He basically starts off with this pattern right here. He starts off with a D note. And what that is just, it's basically a D to F, C. You come back to that F and you vibrate the note a little bit. It's called vibrato. Gives it a little vocal quality, a little bit of feel to it, a little soul. He does it again. So that's the first part of the solo. Then he goes up and bends his G note up to an A. So it's that pattern is just pentatonic. You're bending the G. Got a very bluesy feel to it. You kind of shake that C note, you do it again. So that little, I guess you'd call it maybe like a transition into the next part of the solo. Now the kind of the memorable arpeggio type part of the solo is this. The breakdown of that first part of the solo is just the run from that goes from C, F, I'm sorry, D, F, C, F. (Laughs) that part of the solo, he's taking the G and bending it up to A. Then, like the end of that piece and transitioning up to the next is. Then the memorable melody, basically it's based off of an arpeggio that goes C, A, F, D. Then it moves up. So there you have it, it just repeats itself again. Then when you've done that, now comes the tremolo picking piece. It goes like this. Have that piece. That's some very fast tremolo picking. And the fact of the matter is this song came out 40 years ago is mind-boggling to me. Nobody was playing like that at the time. It wasn't until about 10 years later the guitarist by the name of Yngwie Malmsteen kind of took what Ritchie Blackmore had done and kind of took it into overdrive, but he'd been studying Ritchie Blackmore. Ritchie Blackmore was one of Yngwie's main influences. And it basically started a whole movement called the neo-shred or neoclassical type of movement. And a lot of that fast picking, like I said earlier at the beginning of the lesson, you have to have a fast or a thick guitar pick to pull that off. And it's a lot of 32nd and 64th notes. These are mainly 32nd notes. So after you play the melody that I showed you, it goes right into that fast piece. And the pattern is based off of a 1-2-4 pattern, then a 1-2-4 pattern stretch, and I'll show you what that means. So basically, the notes are A, B flat, and C. Then it moves up a half step and goes B flat, and it stretches the first to second finger a whole step. So it goes B flat to C, but you're using your second finger to D, and you're using your third finger there. Then it goes from C, same pattern, goes C, D, E. So I'll show you slow, then we'll walk through the tremolo piece. And it repeats. So I was showing you slow. So again, it's basically 1-2-4, 1-2-4, 1-2-4, but when you move up on the first half step, you go B-flat to C to D. So you're stretching, instead of just going one half step with your second, between your first finger, your index finger, and your second finger, you're basically moving up a whole step, okay? So I'll show you again slow. And that walk up is basically, you go up to the A note, and the pedal tone there is the E. So you're just pedaling off the E, and you hit A. So you hit A, and then G, then you walk down a half step, and you keep pedaling off that E. So it goes like this again. So when you're playing that tremolo pattern, you have to do up and down picking, also known as alternate picking. You can't do it all down strokes. You can't do it all up strokes. It's got to be with a relaxed wrist, and you've got to get that tremolo piece going. And a good practice for tremolo picking is just to take a note anywhere and just You know, you can mindlessly do this in front of the TV or whatever. Just get your right hand going. You start off slow, and you kind of build it up. You're not going to do that all in one sitting. You just start off slow and work it up to where you can play really fast. I used to think, you know, guitar players, when I was sort of first starting to learn, I'd see a fast guitar player. I think it was all in the left hand. These guys would do stuff, a lot of hammer-ons and pull-offs and a lot of legato stuff. But I realized it really comes from the right hand. In sync with the left hand, you got to have a fast right hand. And that's probably more critical than having just a fast left hand. So pulling off that run requires that tremolo type picking. So here it goes fast, then I'll do that walk down. And then it repeats itself, and you do the walk down again. Now the first time you end the walk down on C sharp, then you go back into the run. The second time you do that descending pattern, you walk it all the way down the neck, you hit it open and you start walking your way up to the neck, you end on C. Then you do this run that goes. So you start, you slide it to A. Then